Subarnapur district or Sonepur district is an administrative district in Western Odisha. Sonepur has a rich cultural heritage and is known as the Mandira Malini town of Western Odisha, with more than 100 temples. The people of the Sonepur region are referred to as Sonpuria. In today's video, we will going to know about some historic facts and unique places of Sonepur. So before jumping to the video, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will notified whenever I post any videos. And there is something important in the last part of the video, so must watch the video till the end. In the 8th century, the region was known as Swarnapur and was ruled by the Vasal. Then the region was ruled by the Somapsis. Around the 10th and 11th centuries, the region was called Paschim Lanka. Historically, the presiding deity of the region was the goddess Lankeshwari. At some point during Somapsis rule, the region was given its current name Subarnapur. It was formally established as a district in 1993. Subarnapur is home to a wide variety of cultural heritage, arts and crafts. The Sonepur area specializes in textiles and terracotta, and Binka produces brass metalworks. Also, there is so many beautiful temples in Sonepur like Paschim Lanka, Lankapodi, Sasisena Kavya, Sureshpuri Temple, Subarnameru Temple and Lankeshwari Temple. Rameshpat Temple situated on the confluence of river Mahanadi and Tir. The lingam of the temple is very old. Lord Kartika and Ganesh along with Goddess Parvati are worshipped here. A Durga temple is also found near the Rameshpat temple, where the image of 10-armed Durga is enshrined. Here Durga is also worshipped as Shakti like Parvati. It is believed that the temple was built by the Chauhans. Patali Srikhetra is a famous place with significant historical importance for Subarnapur district and Odisha. The religious place is associated with Shaktism, Buddhism and Vaishnavism. It is located in the foot of the Trikut Hill at Birmachapur subdivision of Subarnapur district. It widely believed that the ideal of Lord Jagannath, Balabhadra and Devi Subhadra were kept hiding in the cave of the Trikut Hill for a period of 144 years. Pancharatha Temple is a highly reserved shrine at Sonepur in Odisha. This beautiful temple, constructed in chariot size, resembles the Sun Temple at Konark. As many as 5 temples built up on a single platform here. Lord Shiva, Ganesha, Kartikeya and Rishabha along with Goddess Parvati are worshipped here. Most noteworthy feature of the temple is the ideal of Lord Ganesha faces east. Generally, in all Shiva temples, the ideal faces south. It is believed that Pancharatha temple was built by King Bhrimiratha Singhdev to remember the death of his son Prince Somabhusan. Lankeshwari temple is located inside the river Mahanadi at Sonepur town, Subarnapur district. Once upon a time, Sonepur region was known as Paschim Lanka. Goddess Lankeshwari was the presiding deity of Paschim Lanka. Now, Ma Lankeshwari is worshipped by the Kaivrata community of Sonepur and people of Subarnapur district. One can see this temple while traveling on the road connecting Dharamsala, Sonepur and Primrajpur. Papasha Ghat is situated on the bank of river Mahanadi at Binka, 32 km from Sonepur. Emperor Ananga Bhimadeva III got cured from leprosy by passing through the Baravruksha tunnel after taking bath at the ghat. Bhimabhui Samadhi Pitha is situated 30 km away from Sonepur with Samadhi Mandir. A lot of people visit here to see the Mandir. In this district, there is a famous temple called Subarnameru. It is believed that The name Suvarnapur came from the name Suvarnameru temple. It is a Shiva temple and other places in Sonipur. So if it missed by me, then comment on below and let me know. And there are lots of people comment on my channel that why don't you make videos on Sambalpuri language. The answer is, I want to represent my Odisha at national level. So if you all want me to make videos on Sambalpuri, then comment on the videos. I will try to make another one in Sambalpuri language. Jai Ma Sambalpuri.